to be looked at as a subject matter expert, or do you simply want your voice to be heard? These are just some of the questions I will ask those who have asked me, Julian, how should I prepare for my next presentation? You see, it's not a simple answer to give, and that's a question only, honestly, you can answer. But what I can do to assist you is to give you a few things to think about. Whether it be decision makers in your audience, or are you simply speaking in front of your peers and just casually? Whoever the audience may be, you should always make note of how important the presentation is to you. And most importantly, how important the presentation is to the decision maker that picked you. Don't get me wrong, every presentation should be deemed important, but honestly speaking, some of your presentations will hold more weight than others. Taking an assessment of all these factors surrounding your presentation will give you a good estimate of how much work you'll need to complete. There's a lot that goes into delivering a powerful message. The practice hours alone can be a huge turnoff to even the most determined out there. Many people don't want to prepare months in advance for a 45-minute talk. I've had clients who didn't see the point in practicing weekly for an event that was perhaps happening at the end of the year. I'm not here to say that they're wrong in their thinking, because it's ultimately what they want to do, and it's ultimately their reputation that's on the line. But when you get to thinking about your audience, who will be there, what are the backgrounds, the age range, you start to see that the more time you have to prepare, the better your chances are at tailoring a talk specifically for them. You're now doing what you need to do to prepare a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And every time you step on stage, you should be aiming to give a custom-tailored experience to each individual audience member. An experience in which an audience feels like your content is new and they're receiving information that no one else is getting. That's just one part of the many steps it takes to create a memorable presentation, and it will require a lot of prep time. For any presentation, big or small, you have to be clear about your message and how you want to get it across. That means jotting down ideas and really taking the time to strategically brainstorm. Earlier, I mentioned thinking of backgrounds and age ranges of the people you'll be talking to. Those alone are just two pieces that can go a long way in helping you determine how to structure your talk. You have to remember, with any audience, you'll be dealing with people who comprehend and retain information differently. You have to put in the work to attempt to satisfy all of them. I say attempt because realistically, everyone won't be satisfied. There always will be one person who would think you could have presented information differently or you weren't clear enough. But at the end of the day, you must put in the work and you must try. The last prominent factor that you should think about could drastically increase or decrease your prep time. And it depends on if you intend to memorize your content or not. In the past, I've suggested that you should never, ever try to memorize your content. It's too much added pressure. If you forget one line, it could throw off your whole talk. But there are some people who still do it. On the other hand, outlining your content could be just as effective and even more effective. It will help you appear as a more natural speaker and it will give you more range to be as creative as needed. Maybe you don't feel like memorizing or outlining. Maybe you think you could get on stage and just wing it. I would still suggest talking through what you want to say beforehand and becoming comfortable with what you want to say and how you want to say it, especially in the moment. Although it may add a couple of hours into your practice time, it goes a very long way. How important your presentation is will be up to you. You may take it lightly, but remember, it's also your reputation that's online. How far will you go to ensure your reputation doesn't get tainted? If you found this tip useful, please like it and share it. Comment on it as well and let me know what you think. Until next Monday, my name is Julian Leonard, and this tip was brought to you by the Jay Leonard Group.